Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory, lighting some candles, getting some nice incense going. I want to show you in a very quick and easy clinic how you bend styrene for a roll cage. And since I'm going to put a roll cage in the, in the Super GTX here. What you need to do is, there used to be a time when you'd think, oh my God, how am I going to measure the inside, blah, blah, blah. It's not that difficult. But the objective here is to make your first bend, 45, 90 degree angle, right? Or is that a 45 degree? I don't know. But anyway, I use one of these. Very useful, okay? And you're going to see shortly here how we bend it. Okay, so that it's completely straight. It cools off nice and straight like that. Now, here's the thing. For you youngsters, get supervision when you're doing this and do it outside. If you do it inside, wear your respirator, in part because you are going to be melting styrene, which is going to produce fumes. Okay, but anyway, you want to create a roll cage that's going to fit in this interior. So this is how you can eye it more or less. You don't want it, you want it to fit, but you also don't want to go crazy taking measurements and all that, because it's not as difficult as it looks. So somewhere on here, okay? So I'll take my handy dandy pencil and put a little mark right there, okay? And then we bring it over and try to put the flame right over it, right where the mark is, and you just sort of rotate it until the styrene starts to get a little soft, okay? And so you need to do this quickly. And here, right before it, and of course, don't burn yourself, don't... And you hold it there, okay, and you try to hold it straight while it dries. While it cools, and it'll hold its shape. So, press it as tight as you possibly can, and don't worry too much about evening it out or whether one leg is longer than the other. Right now, your main concern is to get it curved and for it to hold its shape, just like that. If for whatever reasons you put it down and one leg is wobblier than the other, come back in and soften the plastic until it sits flush like that. And as I said, don't worry too much about the length of it. Well, worry only if you can't get it in there to fit. But what we're going to do is we're going to cut these flush, and then we are going to get some larger diameter tubing and make shoes for this so that it fits right in there. All right. And once you get this, then the rest is fairly easy to connect. And it's just working with styrene. You could also do this with solid wire. It gets to be a little bit more expensive and harder to cut, blah, blah, blah. But Don Yost makes these out of aluminum. I like to make them out of plastic because then I can paint them whatever color, so that's pretty much it. And then I'm going to cut them even. And as I said, later I will create like a half inch to an inch shoe so that I can raise it up and down depending on how tall I want it, all right? And then I'll run the legs to the back, and maybe one leg to the front here and a shorter one. I'll see how I do it. But this is how you bend styrene so that it keeps its form, and make sure you got one of these. Made out of metal helps, because you just want to be able to hold the thing while it cools and have it hold its shape. Anyway, it's that easy, my friends. So, again, make your roll cages out of styrene, and you could start there. And then later, if you want them out of metal, you can. It's a little bit more labor intensive, but I like my styrene. Alrighty, and look, you can make one of these. I don't know exactly what you could do with that. Maybe beat some eggs. All right, we'll be back, Cranky Head. Stay tuned in for more. Oh, and don't forget to blow out your candle. Hey, everybody. I just wanted to show you the progress we made on the roll cage and what it looks like. There it is. A little bit of fun bending the styrene and then using the glue as a welding component gets it looking like that. So, again, this is some of the inspiration we've gotten from watching a whole bunch of builders, in particular people like Fast Jimmy 71, who makes some very nice builds and roll cages. There it is. You know, if you wanted to see it up close, these were the legs that I was telling you that once you get it in there, you can adjust. I still have to sand it flush so that it sits completely flush to the bottom here. So, this is part of the fun of working with styrene. There it is. You know, and one big concern, of course, is the glass. The glass is going to go. So I drilled these holes that way. Once you snap the build, these will go right through the holes and look like that. And you can glue them in place once the build is ready to go. You can glue them in place. Not a problem. So that's pretty much it. Hope you enjoyed this clinic and got a little bit out of it. And we'll be showing you more along the way. All right, my friends, stay tuned for more.